All right, we're gonna keep it going. Who's ready for the next fight? FYI, this next fight is history in the making. History in the making. Welcoming to the cage first, from the blue corner, put your hands together for Cheetah Figueroa.
Cheetah Figueroa, she is fighting at 155 pounds. She's out of Smith Brothers Mixed Martial Arts. Kevin Smith is, that's his gym. Oh, I'm sorry, out of Amir Academy. Cheetah Figueroa is out of Amir Academy, making her MMA debut. Vaseline, I think they're... I think they're looking for a piece of equipment or Vaseline. I'm not sure what's happening with the commission. Gita is transgender, competing against a man, which is history in the making. Fantastic for everybody, I believe, involved.
And Derek Pony, fighting out of the red corner. Put your hands together for Gregorio Gonzalez.
Gregorio Gonzalez, out of Smith Brothers Mixed Martial Arts. He is making his MMA debut. And, you know, this bout, Cheetah Figueroa, obviously of transgender descent. We had mentioned that earlier. It's a fight in the history, as well as, you know, props to both people for taking this bout.
100%. So a big thing that I believe mixed martial arts is it's sports competition. And so one of the things that we have going on in society is gender identification and so forth. And in my opinion, the way sports competition works, it has to do with biological stuff. I have nothing with anything that people believe in the way that they want to identify themselves or anything along those lines. Totally okay with all of that. But coming to sports competition, I believe the most fair thing is biological competition. And here we see a biological male who now identifies as a woman fighting another biological male, which in my opinion is what's fair. We've seen several women in combat sports, particularly one named Fallon Fox, who is a biological male who now identifies as a woman who fights other women and has actually broken another woman's skull during mixed martial arts competition, which is why I mentioned I don't necessarily think that it is fair that a man who has gone through puberty to go fight women because of the testosterone and the other biological developments that happen through maturity. Here we see Cheetah coming in and banging it out with another guy.
Well, yeah, one thing with Fallon Fox, a name that you had mentioned earlier. Fallon did go through the transition surgery as well as takes the hormones in order to put her body where it's, I think, registers as a female. There's a certain number. I'm speaking completely out of term. But either way, we're talking about Cheetah right now, and Cheetah Figueroa is doing something incredibly courageous and wearing herself as she is, and a big props to both of these fighters.
100% courageous. I agree 100% with that.
All right, starting off to my right, introducing with an amateur record of 0-0 from Amir Academy, natural born wrestler at 151 pounds from Massachusetts, runs with the dog. Put your hands together for Cheetah Figueroa! And the opponent to my left, also with an amateur record of 0-0, fighting out of Smith Brothers. Natural born boxer weighing in at 155 pounds from Tampa, fighting for the family. Put your hands together for Gregorio Gonzalez!
Gregorio Gonzalez.
This fight brought to you by One More Gym, scheduled for three rounds.
We're looking
Let's go.
At your classic matchup of wrestler versus boxer. And I think we're waiting for the referee. I don't know. Yeah, they just pulled Gita out of the cage.
I wonder if they're going to make him take this pants
20
off.
Second quick pause, ladies and gentlemen. 20 second quick pause. Once again, reminder, absolutely no video footage or flash photography for the safety of the fighters.
What's happening is that there is a equipment issue, and they're correcting it right now.
Right, so because she is competing as a male, she needs to have the protective equipment that a male athlete needs to have, meaning that she needs to have a cup on. The referee is not willing to let the match go on without having a cup because his job is the safety of the fighters, and those are the regulations here in Florida. So Gita's in the back getting a cup put on. But as we mentioned earlier with courage.
All right, here we go.
Good job. And you know, that kind of takes a fighter out of their mindset.
Who's ready for this fight? Let's go!
You're about to start a fight, and you know, something like that takes place.
100%. So you're in the zone. Oh, hold on. We got to come back out for a second. I'm really interested, but she still looks calm.
Yeah.
Both of them look calm, collected, not distracted by the moment or things getting pulled out into the side, having a wardrobe thing. They look like they're ready to go to war. And I'm excited to watch this go. I have a ton of respect for Gita, too. Getting in here, coming out and banging, too. Because she had the option of getting in here and fighting girls, and she's like, no. Comes out, bangs on this dude, puts him on his back, and now she's on top. Way to go. I am a Gita fan right now. Get it, girl.
Yeah. Gita did a fantastic job coming out on fire. Throwing a left-right combination. And
great aggression. And she's in top dominant position here.
Raining down punches on Gregorio.
Gregorio's kind of in a bad spot, and she's continuing to stay behind him, ride the hips heavy. She's making him extend a ton of energy, and she's in a very dominant
Cameras
position,
away,
sucking up
Cameras
the single
away.
Leg, and again puts Gonzalez on his back. Wow, mount position.
Security.
We see her sliding over. Nice, getting him away from the cage so that he can't wall walk up. It is much harder to get up from the mount position in the middle of the ring. 2 minutes left on the clock. Plenty of time for Gita to walk away here with a submission or TKO win. Gonzalez is not going to be able to hold her down forever. Now she postures up, and this could be it.
Yeah, Gita is really taking her time right now.
Very smart. She's cooking him. I'm a little surprised that she gave a mount position that easily. There's about 90 seconds on the clock still. And she's accepting here. I would like to see her open her legs, start wall walk. Whoa, triangle. Let's see. It's really hard to finish a triangle choke, though, with these shin pads on. And Gonzalez is doing the right thing by trying to stack her, pop the legs open, and get around. Gita needs to get out from underneath him, though. Gennady escape her hips away and continue to fight up for this transition here.
So we're getting a transition between Gregorio Gonzalez and Gita.
But we don't see much of a choke here. I want to see Gita turn her left shoulder over the top and now turn into Gonzalez and secure top position by punching her left arm up and around and over. He has the head wrap, but there's not enough here to get a choke. Gita just needs to blast through and get to that position.
Yeah, Gregorio is burning a lot of energy here, and there's no end game in regards to
And that right
fight.
Arm is probably the dominant side. If you start gassing out your dominant weapon, you could be in a bad spot for the remainder of this fight. There's still potentially up to 10 minutes left in this match, or 7 minutes. Again, Gita on top, riding Gonzalez. Great position here. I'd like to see her capture that right leg. Oh, it is captured. Continue to use this cradle, put Gonzalez on his back, or get behind him and ride. 30 seconds left on the clock, and this has been a very dominant first round, in my opinion, thus far for Gita, despite spending a little bit of time on her back. Fantastic wrestling there. Picked the leg, landed top position, and Gonzalez again accepts bottom position.
Yeah, I think the hips on Gita is something that was underestimated by Gregorio Gonzalez going into this
Not
bout.
Just the hips, but her ability to control his hips. She's getting in, snatching legs, picking things, doing a great job thus far of technically beating Gonzalez. Very technically.
Oh, end of round. I'll tell you what, Gita belongs here. Fantastic performance.
100%. And I'll be honest, hearing the transgender and surgery things, and hormones make me wonder about an ability to perform against somebody with as much testosterone as a natural male that's
still Yeah, I mean, this is something that we had questions about. Now we're seeing it.
Well, this really shows the value of technique. Gina is winning right now because of technique. Yeah, she's strong and getting in and being aggressive, but she is technically winning this matchup. And this shows the value of technique over anything else in combat sports. I am really impressed thus far. She has been bringing the fight to Gonzalez. Gonzalez needs to do something differently in the second round. He had top position and did very little with it. I'm not sure what the answer is, because Gina came out hands hot, getting the takedown, having great top pressure, and continual aggression while in dominant positions.
Yeah, Gina looked great that round.
Gina staring at him, ready to get back at it. Okay, he's looking too.
Deep breath.
Let's see what he wants to do differently, because I think Gina's going to come out hot on him again.
Hairband.
Oh, nice stiff jab by Gina. Gonzalez wants to get top position. Let's see if he's able to get that left knee to mount, though. There's nothing stopping him from sliding to mount right now, and that could be a very bad position to get secured with 2 minutes and 40 seconds left on the clock. I'm not sure that Gonzalez knows a ton of what to do here. I can't see his hands very well. He's kind of trying to grind here. Gina needs to scoot her hips away, turn face towards Gonzalez and try and get her back to the cage and wall walk up. As long as she stays in this position right here, she's getting full mount. This could be bad, but it doesn't necessarily mean the end.
I think Gina may have had an adrenaline dump in between the rounds.
I mean, but she was really calm underneath when she was on the bottom of the first round too. Gonzalez isn't doing anything with this. He needs to be posturing up and throwing strikes to do some damage, because he's in a very dominant position doing very little. Ooh, this could be a mounted triangle, but like I said earlier, it's really hard to finish a triangle. Now I bet we're gonna see a little bit more aggression and if she's able to get this top position, if she can get her hips under her, ooh, this could be bad for Gonzalez here. He spent a lot of the first round in that turtle position. Halfway through the fight.
I think Gita hit a cardio wall. I think there's some issues with cardio on Gita's end.
You know, it's a debut, but they don't either have a ton of experience. Gina came out and really tried to put it on her opponent in the first round. We're at the halfway point of this fight. Gina's definitely up 1-0, but it could be anybody's fight. It's whoever really wants it more now. Yeah, I think Gonzalez has won so far this round, but Gina can get on top and win this next round. I think whoever really wants it more is going to start taking it away, because once you get exhausted, technique starts going out the window, and heart becomes the lifeline of it. Who's going to fight for it longer? Who's going to fight deeper?
Gina's jab seems to be the difference in the stand-up portion of this bout.
I would say she's committing more to her attacks, and whether it's the jab, the takedown, the strikes, I think we're going to see a ground-and-pound stoppage here.
Yeah, Gina is not laying down.
Yeah, and she's riding, and you notice her hips are on top of his, meaning every time he wants to move, he's moving all of her weight too, which makes it that much more exhausting to move. She's going to pick that hip, roll him down, put him flat, make him accept position, and end the second round on his back, taking shots to the face. A fantastic performance again by Gita, getting this top position.
I think if Gita also could probably do some arm isolations, it would really help her top game as well.
I agree 100%. She's exhausted, though, but the way she's still able to control, I'd like to see her stuff the head, go behind, get behind him, and continue to ride him throughout the rest of the round, even though it's about to end.
Maybe catch your breaths there as well. You know, work hard for that position, and then get the air into your body. I agree. Good show sportsmanship between these two athletes at the end of that round.
100%. Man, you can see a nice mouse under the left eye of Gonzalez. I'm not sure exactly when that popped up.
It was when their back was towards us. It was that jab. Yeah, no, Gita's really throwing her jab very, very well.
Yeah, great commitment to all her strikes. I believe in the first round she came out with a jab cross that really put Gonzalez back on his butt.
Yeah, in terms of technique, however, Gita is miles ahead of Gregorio.
So I'm told that I made a misreport earlier about Fallon Fox breaking an opponent's skull. It was not a skull, it was an orbital bone inside of the face, not a skull. So I apologize for my incorrect information.
Well, I was actually at that fight. Really? I was actually at that fight. Yeah, and it was kind of a surprise to everybody. When, I don't know. It's a different fight, different fighter. Let's concentrate on Gita. This is her
100%,
moment.
100%. And I am extremely impressed with this girl's moment. Performance. A very courageous athlete coming in here, a biological male fighting other biological males. Ton of respect out of me on this. Good. Ooh, and secures top position 10 seconds into the third round. Wow, yeah. What a performance thus far.
Yeah, and I tell you, this is Gita's moment. Let's not concentrate on other things. Let's just focus on her. Gregorio Gonzalez obviously putting up one heck of a fight against Gita. And as we said earlier, the arm isolations.
Yep, oh, 100%. Got that crucifix on an exhausted Gonzalez. This could be it. Not that these are a ton of damage, but he's stuck. He's taking shots. The referee's looking close. This could be it. This could be it. Oh, ton of respect, Gregorio, for continuing to try and scramble out of this position. He's not quitting.
And you know what?
That was a somewhat of an illegal back elbow there from the bottom. But given the referee doesn't stop it because he doesn't want, if he took a point, Gita would lose the position. And in my opinion, on top right now is the better thing. I actually agree with the referee not stopping it to take a point there because of the loss of the top position for Gita.
I'd like to see maybe Gita, you know, continue with the arm isolations, change your position, face Gregorio, make him carry her weight.
I think she also knows that she's up two rounds right now, though, so she's not in a, there's not a ton of urgency. You know, like here, this isn't comfortable, but you know there's not going to be a finish unless he's able to isolate that arm.
It's almost like a Toby Imeda, you know, reverse triangle.
I'm interested to see if he's able to do something with that lead arm, though, because he can secure a double wrist lock grip control. Let's see if he's able to do anything with this. He's got 80 seconds left on the clock. He's not going to be able to finish that head scissor that he's looking for with those shin pads on. And let's see if he's able to do anything with that top arm. Punches to the body aren't going to stop it. I don't think he's going to be able to keep Gita here. I think Gita is going to fight her way out and pop back up and end up on top.
And Gita responding with the head scissors of her own.
Toes in the cage, though. Referee made her pull those out. Not that she was really using it, but it just she kind of needed her feet in that position. Now she's pushing off the face with her feet. Very smart. It looks like he's trying to attack an armbar here, but he doesn't have the right fulcrum to get the armbar leverage for a submission.
You know, making your MMA debut, you never imagine yourself and going through three rounds in a very hard fight. Yeah, this isn't easy for either of these contestants.
No, both of them have really been putting it all on the line. Zero quit. We've seen some fantastic stuff out of both people. This has been a very competitive fight. And a pleasure to call.
Absolutely, 100%, 100%. Yeah, Gregorio Gonzalez has put up a fantastic fight, but I think Gita's just been a little bit too much for him.
I think they're both tired. They're both, like, resting. The referee knows. He's like, all right, come on, stand back up. Y'all are going to bang it out for the last 10 seconds. Come on. And Gita back in his face immediately. I love that. I love when people come out and fight aggressively. Show that sweep.
And that's
Gita
the end of the round.
Gita came out here to fist fight.
I think Gita may have stole that round. I think she may have won all three rounds.
I think so.
Fantastic performance. That I tell you, at the end of 9 minutes, the hardest thing you can do is make a statement in your first fight, and that's what Gita just did.
Yeah,
good
wow.
for her. Good for her. Very emotional between the corner and Gita. Yeah, the thing that excites
give
me is this
up,
is the beginning
up,
of her journey.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's a lot more to come. Win or lose, it doesn't matter. This is who she is, and she's allowing everybody
full
to go through this experience
of action.
With her.
I love it. Let's go.
Here we see the replay, that takedown that Gita landed at the end of the fight in the third round. What a fantastic performance, the aggression out of Gita, incredible performance.
Fighters through center of the cage, please. And after three rounds of exciting action, your winner by unanimous decision, in the blue corner, Gita Figueroa!
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner, Gita Figueroa. Gita, what was the pressure like coming into this bout?
It was a lot on my shoulders. Because I'm doing something that a lot of people don't have the balls to do. And I just did it, so I just want to send a message to anyone that's going through what I'm going through in life or even in sports such as this. I just say, just compete in the gender that you were born in. Stop being a bitch.
Gita, your stand-up, yeah. You came out with heavy punches in every round. Was that your plan going into this?
Yeah. I learned striking early on. Then I found a love for grappling and wrestling in high school. But I never pursued it because no one had support for me. Kind of just did it because I was an angry little person. And I wanted to start and do the striking so we can last and put on a show for you guys. But in the end, jiu-jitsu and wrestling fucking works. And I think everyone should use it.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner, Gita. Congratulations and thank you for joining us, allowing us to join you in your journey.
Give it up for Gita!